Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel. A growing number of passengers and even flight crews are protesting the latest security measures at America's airports, including body scanners and those so-called pat-downs. Jennifer Wishon has that story.
They're now being used at 60 airports, full-body scanners that allow screeners to detect anything hidden on your body. But some fear the machine's radiation is putting passengers at risk.
The risks are still very small, but multiply it by 300 times for a pilot each year, and you're starting to get some concerns, even on an individual basis.
Union leaders are urging flight crews to seek checkpoints that don't have the scanners. Flight crews and passengers can't avoid them, but they must submit to a full-body pat-down by the Transportation Security Administration that some feel is invasive.
We don't want them in uniform going through this enhanced screening where, you know, their private areas are being touched in public.
Still, some pilot unions are encouraging members to go ahead with the pat-down and then assess whether they're emotionally fit to fly after their encounter with TSA. But some flyers say they're okay with a little radiation and occasional pat-down in the name of safety.
If it's needed and it keeps us safer, then I'm fine with it.
One passenger who's fed up with the body scans has started a website encouraging passengers to opt out of standing in the machines and request a pat-down on one of the busiest travel days of the year, the day before Thanksgiving. Since pat-downs take longer, the idea is to cause delays, sending a message to the government. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News.
Passengers of that stranded cruise ship are waking up to hot showers, coffee, and a real breakfast today. The Carnival ship Splendor finally made it back to San Diego Thursday after being towed home when a fire killed the ship's engines. Passengers have tales to tell of living 3 days without power, while some toilets stopped working and food rotted around them. But many came through with humor intact, and some are even ready to take up Carnival Cruise Line's invitation to head back to sea with a complimentary cruise.
What are the chances this would happen twice to the same person? So I'm going with the odds.
A power blew due to a smoke fire. The toilets did not work. Our food was vegetables and fruit on the 2-day return.
We can beat anybody's bad honeymoon story. We got it beat, except for the honeymooners that were on the boat with us.
The Navy kept the ship supplied while it was towed back to land, but Carnival reports that its passengers were never served Spam. President Obama has moved on to the next leg of his Asian tour, a regional economic summit in Tokyo. But he left the G8 summit in South Korea without reaching a trade deal with the Koreans. And that deal was one of his main objectives. Obama did confront China before leaving, though. He spoke out against Chinese attempts to manipulate their currency and undercut the rest of the world's manufacturing. Critics complain that by keeping its currency artificially low, China makes its products cheaper and steals American jobs. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu held marathon talks on Thursday. The U.S. is trying to restart Israeli-Palestinian negotiations. A joint statement said officials would meet in the coming days to create conditions for resuming direct negotiations. The talks stalled after a 10-month Israeli construction freeze expired. The U.S. has been trying to pressure Israel to reinstate the freeze, but former Israeli Ambassador Zalman Shoval told CBN News settlement freeze is not the answer.
One must be completely blind not to understand that if Israel were to agree to another freeze for another 3 months, that at the end of those 3 months, the Palestinians won't come up with another demand for another freeze.
Earlier this week, Israel angered Washington by announcing the start of new building projects in eastern Jerusalem. Shoval says the U.S. position only encourages Palestinians to dig their heels in further. And earlier, Heather Sells spoke with CBN News Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell for more on the trials Israel is facing.
Chris, do you think that Netanyahu is going to be able to withstand that increasing White House pressure to renew the freeze on Israeli construction?
I think he will, Heather. And the reason is he's not only facing pressure from the White House and the Obama administration, but he's also faces pressure from his own internal government. You know, he has a coalition government of right-wing parties, and many of those were adamant against the freeze in the first place, this 10-month temporary freeze. So if he gives in to the Obama administration, it threatens his own coalition and whether his government can survive.
But this is obviously a priority of his. He's been making multiple trips to the U.S. in recent months.
Right. He's trying to walk a tightrope between the pressure he's receiving from the Obama administration and the pressure he's receiving from the right-wing parts of his government, and also his own internal principles. I mean, when they talk about coming against construction in Jerusalem, that is a very sensitive area in Israel and for Jews around the world. I mean, this has been their capital for 3,000 years, and it's sort of one of the red lines that Israel will be hard to press to cross.
Okay, now what happens to Israel if they do freeze construction, if this keeps going on?
Well, if it keeps going on, it makes it harder to unfreeze the construction. I mean, they went through 10 months of this temporary freeze, and many projects were put on hold. There actually were some construction going on during that time, construction permits that had previously been permitted, but it makes it harder to unfreeze it, and it just creates more problems, internal tension within Israel itself. Because this is not only an issue between the Obama administration and the Netanyahu government, but it's a huge issue within Israel itself.
So you're saying there's a sense of urgency at this point to really move this forward?
I think so. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Okay. Now, I know Canada's prime minister says he will stand with Israel no matter what. Now, that's a rare show of support, isn't it?
It is. And it's a big contrast between Canada and the United States. I mean, the United States is coming out consistently against any kind of construction within Judea and Samaria, what's known as the West Bank, or Jerusalem itself. So the Canadian prime minister has really taken a bold stand, in behalf of Israel and in defense of Israel. He's done that consistently, and I know believe some of it, many of it, comes from his Christian beliefs.
Netanyahu told the UN General Assembly this week that now is the time to fight rising anti-Israel sentiment. Are you seeing that rising sentiment?
I think we are. We see it particularly in the European Union, in the European nations. We certainly see it in the Middle East. I think the United States would be an exception to that, but because there's broad support for Israel, for construction in Judea and Samaria. But there is rising anti-Semitism, and there's not only anti-Semitism, there's a demonization of Israel and delegitimization and undermining the very notion of an Israeli state, of a Jewish state in the Middle East.
All right. Netanyahu also reminded the UN that, quote, the greatest danger facing Israel and the world is the prospect of a nuclear-armed Iran. What do you see Israel doing about that threat at this point in time?
Well, what they're doing right now is they're trying to convince other nations, particularly the United States, that Iran is a threat not only to Israel, but the Middle East, Europe, and the world itself, and to the United States as well. So they're trying to make a convincing argument about that. They're also preparing militarily. It's very unlikely that you ever get an Israeli official to talk much about Iran, but they certainly have military plans to make a military strike against Iran. When that might happen, I think they're playing a game right now of deciding how important are the sanctions, how effective are they, and how much they're willing to go along with the international community. And then when they have to make a decision on their own to say, we're going to have to attack Iran because it's posing an existential threat to the Jewish state.
All right, Chris Mitchell, all the way to Virginia Beach from Jerusalem. Thank you.
Okay, Heather. Great to be with you.
As Americans pause to celebrate Veterans Day, one military chaplain publicly thanked God for veterans. During the Veterans Day ceremony at Arlington National Cemetery, Chaplain Keith Etheridge called veterans God's gift to America and said their gift to the world is freedom. Etheridge also asked God to watch over the nation's veterans and their families. In Michigan, Veterans Day could not have been more fitting for some families of Army National Guard soldiers who greeted them after returning home from Iraq.
It's surreal. I didn't think that it would come so fast, but it just feels so great. I can't even put it into words.
She's my baby. Yeah, it was scary when they left, and you know, I fretted the whole time, but yeah, she's home today.
The service members had been in Iraq for the last year. And one man's 50-state odyssey to honor America's war dead, including his own son, wrapped up at Arlington National Cemetery on Veterans Day. Paul Strand was there and brings us that touching story.
Over the last 5 months, George Lutz has traveled across the country presenting specially designed honor and remember flags to family members of troops who have been killed. Thursday at Arlington National Cemetery, he and supporters placed thousands of small flags by tombstones of those killed in Iraq and Afghanistan.
Help honor those who have given ultimate sacrifice. I'm a veteran as well, and it's a great way to celebrate Veterans Day.
Among those Lutz is honoring, his own son Tony, who died in Iraq 5 years ago.
He was in Fallujah, Iraq, when he was killed. He was killed by a sniper's bullet. Very smart gregarious man, athletic, loved what he was doing, loved his country, loved the mission, and loved his God. Strong man of faith, and lost my best friend that day. It was a tough, tough day.
Lutz says it's about time those who gave so much for others have their own flag.
We have flags for every state, we have flags for every city, every branch of the service has a flag. Everybody has a flag. But the one group that enables us to fly all of those flags have no symbol. And that is why the Honor and Remember flag is so important.
Lutz is asking all the states to adopt the Honor and Remember flag as a special way to memorialize the nation's fallen troops. Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Arlington National Cemetery.
This Sunday, Christians around the world will remember their brothers and sisters in Christ who suffer for their faith. The International Day of Prayer for the Persecuted Church mobilizes churches on behalf of the millions persecuted Christians around the world. This Sunday, they'll be joining together in prayer and learning about practical ways they can help suffering the church. You can find links to resources for your church at cbnnews.com. Coming up, braving rough weather and stormy seas to help tsunami victims. 2 weeks after the disaster, some are only now just getting the help they need.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart.
These are the most powerful songs of our time. And now, for the first time, the biggest praise and worship songs are together.
How great is our God.
Presenting Songs for Worship 50. 50 songs in one specially priced collection.
Holy is the Lord, God Almighty. The earth is filled.
You'll hear 50 beautiful songs of hope.
I'm coming back to you.
50 powerful songs of faith. Get Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for only
$24.99.
But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card and we'll take $15 off. That's right. You get 50 praise and worship songs for just $9.99. Then preview other great praise and worship collections. Satisfaction guaranteed.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
So call now and get Songs for Worship 50. 50 beautiful songs on 3 CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-435-3414 to order Songs for Worship 50 on 3 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Call now or order online at timelife.com/songsforworship50.
The United Nations is warning about a major outbreak of cholera in Haiti. The disease has now claimed more than 700 lives, and it's infected more than 11,000 people in five of Haiti's 10 districts, including more than 200 people in the capital, Port-au-Prince. Operation Blessing is in Haiti, helping to fight the outbreak with water purification equipment. Parts of Indonesia are still struggling to recover from the tsunami that killed hundreds and did massive damage last month. Relief crews have struggled to get to remote islands virtually cut off by bad weather and rough seas. As Lucille Talusan reports, teams from Operation Blessing have made it through and are bringing help to those victims.
From big ships to medium boats and even smaller boats, the Operation Blessing team, by all means, had to bring the food, clothing, medicines, and other relief goods to the tsunami victims.
The Operation Blessing team need to sail through rough seas and even strong rains just to get food to the islands that have been affected by the tsunami. Here we see the boxes of noodles being wheeled to the residents of the island here. And the most important help that they get is medical help, which most of the islanders get for the very first time.
There were times Operation Blessing had to stop sailing because the waves got too high. But even the bad weather turned providential for 11-year-old Rekha, who for 5 days was in excruciating pain after she fractured her leg when she was swept by the tsunami. The Operation Blessing team stopped at her village, and an orthopedic doctor applied first aid to Rekha's fractured leg. Rekha and her parents are grateful.
We are very thankful that you came to our village. Thank you for helping our daughter.
Villagers say the Operation Blessing workers were the first to bring them help. 6-year-old Nelmi was treated for a cut in her thigh. Her brother says a sharp object sliced into her body when she was swept away by raging waters.
I'm happy my sister is alive. Thank you so much for treating her wound.
In the island of Maunae, Christian relief workers joined the Operation Blessing team in comforting families of the dead. Village Chief Jonathan Samaloisa can't contain his grief. He lost his wife and 2 children. They are among 36 people in his village who died in the tsunami. Maria Endang of the Christian organization Rebana is saddened that the school they built for the children was destroyed.
The school is gone, but we shall build another one to teach the people here the value of education.
The Operation Blessing team also brought spiritual help. Most of these villagers are animist.
I believe God allowed this tragedy to happen so that the people of Mentawai will return to Him and place their faith in Jesus Christ. I am here to encourage the people that God is a God who builds and not one who destroys.
Despite hardships and dangers, the Operation Blessing team leader says the staff and volunteers feel they are privileged to help.
It was very difficult, but we are happy to be involved in such a ministry that helps those who are in great need.
And Operation Blessing says it won't be leaving here anytime soon. A new team of doctors has arrived, and more relief goods will be distributed to the more remote islands in the coming weeks. Lucille Talusan, CBN News, Mentawai Islands, Indonesia.
Up next, facing big budget cuts even though demand is way up. Why many Americans say local libraries are worth the cost.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth.
These are the greatest stories ever told. Presented by Academy Award winner Charlton Heston.
Thus saith the Lord of Israel, let my people go.
Join Charlton Heston as he travels the sacred lands of the Bible.
I'm going to take you with me on a journey. A journey exploring stories in the Bible and the ancient land where they happened.
This is said to be the very garden. This the very rock where Jesus prayed for strength.
Now the Bible comes to life like never before. Time Life presents Charlton Heston's The Bible.
And Moses cast the tablets from his hands.
Praised by critics, this landmark TV series is now available on digitally remastered DVDs. You'll be inspired by the greatest stories from the Old and New Testaments, enhanced by historic works of art. Get Charlton Heston Presents the Bible on 4 DVDs for $49.99. Call with your credit card and save $10.
And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son.
And that's not all. You'll also get a free bonus DVD that takes you behind the scenes. And if you call in the next 10 minutes, we'll ship for free. That's an additional savings of nearly $7.
The thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever.
Call now to get Charlton Heston's The Bible on 5 DVDs for just $39.99. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll ship for free.
Now therefore go, and I will be with thee.
Call 1-800-748-5167 to order Charlton Heston Presents The Bible for $39.99 and receive free shipping when you call in the next 10 minutes with your credit card.
Amazon.com is no longer selling an e-book guide for pedophiles. The self-published book offers advice on sexual encounters with children. Customers became outraged after finding it for sale on Amazon's website. Over 10,000 signed a petition to boycott the online store. Amazon responded by saying it does not censor what books are sold, but now the item is no longer on the site. It's unclear whether Amazon or the author pulled it off. And profanity on television is spiking. A new study from the Parents Television Council says profanity on primetime TV has skyrocketed 69% in the last 5 years. In 2010, 111 F-words were used during family hour, compared with 10 in 2005. The president of PTC says the spike came after a court threw out the FCC's authority to enforce the broadcast decency law. Public libraries across America are facing their greatest budget cuts since the Depression. But at the same time, demand for libraries is up, thanks to people looking for information about jobs and families who want free entertainment. Heather Sells has the story.
Your local library may be quiet, but it's still one of the busiest places in town. For the past 10 years, Americans have steadily increased their use of these historic institutions. And now, in the midst of the toughest economy in a generation, they're coming in droves.
So I come here, get my books, get my studies done, do my searches, everything. It's like the best place to be when you need something done.
In recent years, libraries have transformed, erasing questions about whether they can stay up to date. They've embraced the online world, and now communities are rallying behind them as budget cuts threaten. Recent polls show most public libraries face a loss in funding. That usually results in fewer librarians, fewer hours, and in some cases, closing the doors altogether. This fall, cities from San Diego to Boston are considering library shutdowns. That almost happened in Philadelphia, Indianapolis, and Charlotte. But it's too late for others in North Carolina and Northern Michigan.
We're, you know, terribly depressed at what's happened in some places, and the main reason is because the impact it's going to have on the people in the community.
Communities, says Fields, like Milwaukee, recently cited by the U.S. Census as the fourth poorest city in the U.S.
The city of Milwaukee has long appreciated its public libraries. Its beautiful Central Library, built in 1898, boasts millions of books and special collection materials. So it was a major blow last year when the city had to cut $1.7 million from its library budget.
The public library is really that safety net or that bit of insurance that you don't have to buy information.
But that safety net is not so safe now. Budget cuts mean Milwaukee libraries have had to cut some evening hours and close on one weekend day. It's tough, not only for book lovers and information seekers, but for those who use the library as a lifeline.
For those of us that use computers every day, we take that for granted. You know, that's another tool, my computer or my iPhone or my PDA. But for a lot of people, they don't own these things, or they don't have access for a job. And so the public library becomes one of the few sources of that technology for them.
Indeed, two-thirds of libraries nationwide now help patrons with online job hunting. And 70% provide the only free access to computers and the internet in some communities.
When you think about it, a library is the only government entity that's whose doors are open all the time. There are people there to help you. It has access to virtually all of the information in the entire world.
Field says public officials are beginning to appreciate libraries in a new way, thanks to citizens pushing to keep doors open and lights on. There's also a growing recognition that libraries are critical to the next generation. Ruby Fountain is one parent that gets it. She brings her three children every day after school.
They love the library. They think that this is just the best place in the world because they are truly, they love books.
And Fountain's kids also love the computer.
I think it's more resourceful to come to the library than it is paying the extra money for the internet at home.
In a changing world, library advocates say there is one mission that remains the same, reaching and teaching children to prepare them for tomorrow's challenges.
I think that libraries' role in our educational system is totally underrated. You have a kid in school for 6 hours a day, you've got another 18 hours, and the question is the degree to which somebody becomes an independent learner.
The end goal, help communities not just survive today's economic realities, but thrive in a 21st century world where change is the new normal. Reporting in Milwaukee, Heather Sells, CBN News.
And we'll be right back.
These are the most powerful songs of all time. Songs of strength and majesty. Time Life proudly presents Classical Power. You'll get five CDs for a very special price. You'll hear more than 6 hours of timeless classics by the world's greatest composers. Call now to get Classical Power on five CDs for just $29.99. But wait, order in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, and we'll cut the price to just $14.99. That's right, you get five powerful CDs for the incredible price of $14.99. Then preview other beautiful classical CDs. Satisfaction guaranteed. This special collection is not sold in stores. So call now and get Time Life's Classical Power on five CDs for just $14.99.
Call 1-800-734-9164 to order Classical Power on five CDs for $14.99 plus shipping when you call in the next 10 minutes with your credit card, or order online at timelife.com/power.
Finally today, a North Carolina bridal store is giving wedding dresses to some very deserving ladies. The gowns were set aside for brides-to-be who have fiancés serving in the military overseas. In honor of Veterans Day, Bridal World Dress Store donated dozens of dresses. The store owner says it is a way to show her appreciation for military families and give military fiancés a chance at their dream wedding. The designer gowns range in prices from $300 to $3,000. Nearly 57 dresses have been given away so far.
I'm super excited because it's my first time trying on a wedding dress. He's already been twice. Probably have to deploy again, I don't know. So we're just trying to get married so we can be together.
They're very appreciative, and a lot of them just are on a very low budget, and it was just great. It's an opportunity to say thank you to our military who lay their lives down every day for us.
The giveaway is part of a nationwide organization called Brides Across America. The store plans to give away a total of 117 bridal gowns. A really neat way to be a blessing. That is all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find information on all the stories you've seen here at cbnnews.com. You can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us next time, everybody. Have a great day.
Fresh, wholesome juice. There's nothing like it. But until now, you had to stress and strain and make a huge mess to get just a little bit of juice. But not anymore, thanks to the Jack LaLanne Power Juicer. You can drop in whole vegetables, whole fruits, apples, oranges, celery, cucumbers with no chopping, no slicing, no struggling. And thanks to the Power Juicer's revolutionary patented extraction technology, you can get up to 30% more juice than those other juicers. Doctors recommend we get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. With the Power Juicer, you'll be drinking your recommended daily allowance
in just seconds. And the pulp from the extra large pulp catcher can be used to make pasta sauces, healthy desserts, and much more. The power juicer is dishwasher safe, so cleanup's a breeze, and the powerful motor is guaranteed for life. Order the Jack LaLanne power juicer now for just 2 easy payments of $49.90. And as part of this special TV offer, we'll also send you this amazing recipe guide filled with over 60 of Jack's favorite recipes. Try the Jack LaLanne power juicer in your home risk-free for 30 days. If you're not completely satisfied, send it back for a full refund of the purchase price, no questions asked. Call now.
I was always on the cusp of exploding. So I figured out if I get rid of the wife and the kids, then I can just send them money. Went to the junk drawer, I got the Bible out, put the tape in, and I believe that moment, Christ made sense. There is no earthly reason why we're still married. It is a divine intervention, and I thank God, in showing me what love, grace, and forgiveness.